Hello guys, in the previous lecture I have gone through the concept of how current flows through a semiconductor specimen, and now I have gone through the concept of drift. That is, I have completed the concept of drift. That is how a current flows through a specimen of semiconductor when we provide an extra external electric field to that crystal. Now what is the current equation that I have got in my previous lecture was magnitude of current I have got was I equals to mu n V by L W width into length, width into height, W into H into N into Q, where n equals to what? N is the concentration of electrons. We are taking silicon silicon specimen, that's why I am taking this expression, as we have gone through this expression in my previous lecture. Now this is the total current that is passing through a crystal in response to the voltage source V which we have applied across that specimen or semiconductor. Now from this we can calculate the resistance value. How we will calculate the resistance value? We can easily calculate the resistance of specimen through V by magnitude of that current I. Now for this, from this equation you can easily calculate V by I. So you will get L by mu n W into H into N into Q. This expression you will get for the value of resistance, and on comparing with R equals to rho into L by A, you will get rho equals to 1 by mu n into Q. That is what, if we will increase the mobility of the semiconductor, resistivity will decrease, hence conductivity will increase. We can say that. Now I'm going to introduce a term known as current density. Current density in my lecture. Now it is represented by Jn. And how you can express it as current per unit area. We can write W into H as cross sectional area A. We can write it as cross sectional area A. Now from this expression you can get the value of Jn. Jn we will get as mu n into V by L into N into Q. Q is the electronic charge. Now you can write as potential per unit length as electric field applied across the crystal. We can easily write it as, then what will be the value of Jn will be mu n E into N into Q. We will get this value. What is the unit of this? Is ampere per centimeter square. Now this is the case when electrons is carrying the current. Now let's conclude a new thing. When if holes also carrying the current across the specimen, that is we are considering P type of material, that is when a silicon is doped with boron, that is when hole will also contribute, what will happen to the current expression, current density expression and all? When holes will conduct the current, then you can write it as, then the total current density expression, total current density expression will be what? You can write it as mu n E n q for electron mobility, electron carrying the current plus current flowing in the spaceman due to what? Due to holes. You can write it as, I will write as mu p into p into q into e. This is because of holes. Current flowing, that is the current density due to holes. Now, this is the total current density. That is the current density due to electron flowing. That is the current flowing due to electron. And this is the current flowing due to hole carrier concentration. Now, you can write this expression as J total equals to mu n into n plus mu p into p, taking common as E into Q. This is the entire equation. Now we know that mu n will be the mobility of the electron inside the specimen, mu p will be the mobility of holes inside the crystal. You can take mu p value nearly equals to 400 centimeter square per volt second. Now, drift completed means the current through this specimen, because of the drift, that is by providing extra external electric field, is completed. Now, there is second way, current also flows through this specimen, semiconductor specimen, and the second way is the concept of diffusion. Just I am going to discuss about the current, transportation of current of current in semiconductor specimen due to diffusion. In layman language or in normal ways, if I am going to explain you diffusion, I will tell you example of how we can explain diffusion. Let's take a glass of water. एक glass of water लेते हैं. अब क्या करते हैं? Just pour few ink drops in it. After few seconds, what you will observe? This ink drop will be spreading in the entire fluid or in the entire liquid or water. What is this process? This is the process of intermixing of ink in water. That is movement of ink from a higher region, from a region to higher concentration to a region to lower concentration. This is known as diffusion. What do you mean by the term diffusion? Diffusion is the movement of charge carrier from a region of high concentration to a region of lower concentration. मतलब high carrier, high concentration से lower concentration पे without providing any external electric or any external force. हम बस छोड़ दे रहे हैं. वो खुद से खुद कुछ cover कर ले distance. Electron, if electron will cover a distance inside the specimen, there will be a current. अब क्या होगा? वो हम लोग देखेंगे diffusion के कारण. Or you can also explain diffusion as in a non-uniformly doped semiconductor crystal. एक crystal लेंगे, non-uniformly doped, charge carrier move from higher concentration to lower concentration due to concentration gradient. There is a term known as concentration gradient. What is the meaning of term gradient? Gradient means slope. That is, जब भी concentration gradient आएगा, if the charge will fill, there is a concentration gradient, concentration difference, it will flows. That is from higher concentration to a region to a lower concentration region, and you may call it as if I will compare it in physical world, you may call it as, it will try to achieve the equilibrium position. Until and unless there will be no extra external force we have provided as a potential or as electric field in the specimen or crystal. Now, at that time, when the current exists in that crystal, because of what? Because of concentration gradient. In absence of electric field, this current is known as diffusion current. Current existed in the crystal in absence of electric field, extra external electric field, because of concentration gradient, is known as diffusion current. I think you all are little much aware about the diffusion concept. Now, let me take you all through another level of level for diffusion. Now, let me explain. I am taking a crystal. I am taking an N-type semiconductor. And I am doing what? I am just injecting electrons. When I am injecting electrons, it is very clear that here the concentration of electron is high, that is higher concentration of electrons. That is, if we will plot a curve between what? Between concentration to the distance that electron will travel inside the specimen, that is x. We will get roughly, graph will be like this, or the concentration will decreases as distance traveled by the electron increases. No. There are so many question arises, like electron will flow like this, current will flow like this, and this will provide the gradient or slope. Now, what you can observe through when we will inject electron is this. We will find there will be an electrons that will flow from higher concentration to lower concentration without providing any external electric field to this specimen. How this is possible? Then there comes a term known as current density, which is expressed as current crossing per unit area. So you can write it as, it will proportional to the gradient. Means, if there will be more gradient, the more electron will flow from a higher potential to lower potential, and more current will flow from this to this direction. You can write it like this. Now, so you can write it as J is directly proportional to gradient, that is D by DX, as I am taking N-type semiconductor and injecting electron. So we will take DN, that is electron concentration. Now, to remove this proportionality constant, we will introduce a term J equals to D N dN by dx. Now, this will represent the concentration of electron. So, I will multiply it with the charge so that to give the exact value of current flowing across that specimen through which we have injected the electrons. This constant is known as diffusivity constant. Diffusivity constant, sorry. Of electrons. Diffusivity constant of electrons. Diffusivity constant of electrons. J equals to dN dN by dx into Q. If assume if both electrons and holes are present. So if electron will move in this direction, we all know that holes will move in this direction. So the net current density equation will be what? You can write it as J equals to dN by dx minus, I have subscripted N because of electron, then I will subscript it with P for holes, dP by dx, I will take common Q. This is the electronic charge. So you can write like this. This is the entire equation. If both electrons and holes will participate in current conduction through diffusion. If both will participate in current conduction, you can write like this. Now, this is the important equation. We have to remember this. Now, let me move a little bit more further. Now, I am again taking a N-type specimen. N-type semiconductor. And I will again inject electrons. Let me plot the concentration variation with respect to distance traveled by the electron and holes. First, I am taking N-type specimen, so I will more focused about electrons. So let me draw the plot. On this axis, I am taking concentration, and this axis, the distance traveled by the electron. Practically, the electrons, when electron I have injected from here, when it will start moving, there will be further few recombinations will be there. If there are few holes are present in N-type semiconductor, then there will be few recombinations will be there. So the plot will be like this. That is, it will decrease like this. This represents distance traveled by the electrons or the carrier concentration which we are taking. Now, draw another plot. This is the motion of electron, concentration of motion of electron. I am just drawing. Another plot will be for current. As we know that J equals to dN by dx. That is a slope negative, that is a slope of current will be the slope of the concentration difference gradient, that is the slope of gradient. The slope is what is going like this. So we will get a current plot will be like this. Now there is a term in started to wander in our mind that why J decreases as time increases. Why? There is an observation. Injected electrons recombine with holes in the semiconductor. So J decreases as we move further in crystal. जैसे ही हम लोग मूव करेंगे
injected electron will move, and there will be a recombinations of electrons with holes. That is, there will be a lower concentration of electron motion from this side of that is densely populated to this side. Hence, J will decrease. Hence, J is decreasing. Now, if what will happen to this plot if there will be no recombination? The plot will go like this. No recombination plot. What I am considering here is that if density of holes is very small, so there will be no recombination. Practically, the value of dN will be nearly equals to 34 centimeters square per second, and dP will be nearly equals to 12 centimeters square per second. Now, let me conclude both these things, drift and diffusion together. That is, both are allowing the specimen to flow the current. That is, current flow karne ka do karan hoga. Pehla karan diffusion ke karan current flow karega. Dusra karan drift ke karan current flow karega. But in dono ki wajah se current flow karega hamare semiconductor specimen mein. So we can recombine both. That is, what will be the current equation when current flow due to drift, and what will be the current equation when current flow through diffusion. So you can write for drift, as we remember in my previous lecture, I have concluded mu n into n plus mu p into p electric field into q. Drift diffusion equation dn, I have just concluded dn by dx minus of dp dp by dx into q. Now it is very much clear about how a current flows through a semiconductor specimen. That is, there are two ways for the combination of current flows in a semiconductor specimen. That is, first is drift, second is diffusion, and I have concluded the relationship between both. Now there is an Einstein relationship. Physics is zero without Einstein. So, इसको तो आना ही था. He has introduced a relation for simplification. That is, D, that is diffusivity constant, by mu, mobility constant, will be equals to a constant KT by Q, which is mathematically equals to T by 11600 volt. What is K here? K is Boltzmann constant. T is temperature in degree Kelvin. Q is charge. This is known as thermal voltage. What is the value of K, Boltzmann constant? Its value is approximately 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 joule per degree Kelvin. T in degree Kelvin. We can also known as, it can be expressed as VT. Now, this is Einstein constant, so you can write it as d by mu equals to vt. D equals to mu into vt. D is diffusivity and mu is mobility. Dn by mu n equals to dp by mu p. It is expressed as vt. That is the, you can write it as like this, where mu n, that is mobility of n concentration, that is electronic concentration, is greater than mu p, and dn is greater than dp.
In semiconductor crystal, you can write J total equals to J diffusion plus J drift.
This is all about current conduction in semiconductor. अब देखो, current तो flow कर गया हमारे specimen से, मतलब हमारा एक aim था कि मैंने resistance जान लिया, फिर current को flow करा दिया हम अपने specimen से, फिर हमको पता चला कि there are two ways to current conduction, that is first way is drift, second way is diffusion. हमने दोनों को elaborate कर लिया, फिर हमने देखा कि दोनों का combinations हो रहा है, फिर मेरे holes और electrons कैसे कैसे act कर रहा है, वो भी हमें पता चल गया. तो अब एक और चीज हमारे सिस्टम में इंट्रोड्यूस हो रहा है, वो है पीएन जंक्शन और डिफरेंट डिफरेंट एनर्जी बैंड्स. दैट इज हाउ इलेक्ट्रॉन विल प्रोसेस डिफरेंट इन एनर्जी लेवल्स इन मेटल, इन सेमीकंडक्टर, इन इंसुलेटर, बट आवर मेन फोकस विल बी सेमीकंडक्टर. सो आई होप यू ऑल आर एंजॉयिंग माय लेक्चर, एंड इफ देर इज एनी डाउट, इफ एनीथिंग दैट यू वांट टू इम्प्रूव और इफ एनीथिंग दैट यू वांट टू इंक्लूड इन माय लेक्चर, सो यू हैव टू राइट इट इन कमेंट सेक्शन. एंड प्लीज just try to write the things which you want in my lectures. I will explain all the things which you want through my lecture. Thank you so much.